Hi guys, it's Kay from Happy Trails Hiking. This video is about Scotty's Castle and its restoration after a flood in 2015.
So this morning we're headed to Scotty's Castle. Yes, it's closed. Yes, they had a flood in 2015. And we're gonna get to go anyway. We're one of a very few number of people who are getting to go with the Death Valley Historical Preservation Society. And we're excited about the restoration that's happening and excited to show you that today. So we're headed up to the Grapevine Ranger Station, and we're not sure what we're gonna see or what kind of tour we're gonna get, but we're gonna show you what we can show you.
Imagine this is it's been repaired enough for a car to get through it, but other than that, we've got large sections of washouts. They're gonna get larger. The power poles have been repaired, so generally this is what I saw the first time I came here a couple days after the flood, except that the power poles were splintered. There were none in this section of the canyon.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, so even the power poles were knocked down?
Yeah, everything.
Whoa.
And this section that you see here, this part of this, this is all cut from the flood.
Yeah.
Wow.
We just arrived at Scotty's Castle, and we're here in the parking lot, and that big hill over there, the mud, is what they pulled out of this parking lot after the flood.
Period of significance for Scotty's Castle, which is important that I say it in that way, because it's the way that we maintain the castle, is I believe it's 1907 to 1954. So it's the Johnsons' occupation of this area, but that certainly by no means means that was the first occupation of this area. They have found a cabin of people that the Johnsons actually kind of like shooed off, and they figured out that that was a family through some of the archaeology work that has been going on. They thought it was a bachelor's, this is just a digression, sorry, but they thought it was a bachelor's cabin, and then they found a doll's leg and some corset stays, like, through the archaeology work that we've been doing here, so it's like super, yeah, there was a wife and a child, yeah, and the Johnsons ran them off. We kind of have a very vague story about that, but we didn't know if that was the same cabin or not. We also had, obviously, Native Americans here for a very, very long time when the Johnsons bought this property. And even through the Johnsons doing this, the Native people were the largest group of people who helped the Johnsons build this castle, the unskilled laborers who were here. So they lived in this area, and they lived down over the hill at Grapevine in the largest concentration of any place in Death Valley because of the water that's here. It's also the reason that Scotty's Castle is located here. And they bought this place from a man named Jacob Steininger, who was a rancher, probably a murderer. He sold the land to them, and then they eventually created this place. And Scotty kind of took them on to this location because he was very familiar with Death Valley. And we'll talk about who all these people are, kind of, and how they got into this mess as we go along, and kind of see different things. So we're going to go around the grounds. Thank you. time, and we were showing that we're going to start to make some of the plans to fix Scotty's castle. This is the point at which we figured out that you see a ton of the damage. And then after some of the USGS work that they did, we figured out why exactly. So let me show you kind of the dynamics of the flood. And it's kind of a very confusing and interesting thing that happened. So this is the National Weather Service publication kind of that they threw out after the flood. And it kind of gives a timeline of what was happening and when. It was over a period of 5 or 6 hours that we had about right here, right over Scotty's castle, we had about 2.75 inches. And then, see, I have this thing. 2.72 inches. And then in this area, they had about 3.5 inches coming from generally right up in those hills up there. And the yearly rainfall for Death Valley, like down at Furnace Creek, is 2 inches. Down on the Salt Flats, it might be a little bit less. And then up here, because we're in the mountains, we're at 3,000 feet, and we're in the Grapevine Mountain Range. This is the Grapevine Mountains. We get a little bit more. So from a USGS publication they put out in the 1980s, they estimated the yearly rainfall at about 4 inches a year. They got 3.5 inches in 5 hours right here, and about, you know, well over half of it, 3/4 of the year's worth of rainfall in 5 hours, about a year's worth of rainfall in 5 hours right in this area. So that is why we had such a massive flood in this area.
This picture shows the mud and debris that has flowed onto the property the day after the storm. The powerhouse at Scotty's Castle was personally engineered by its owner, Albert Johnson, who is an engineer, and his generators created enough power to run the whole property.
Picture of the inside, how it was furnished at the time with the Johnsons. This was, this is Bessie sitting all the way on the right of the photo. Wait, the left of the photo. Her right. Mr. Johnson's on the right, and then Scotty's in the middle. And that was generally how we had the castle furnished. That's basically what you would have walked in to see at the time, or I mean just last year, and at the time as well. So that was one thing that we maintained, was that we wanted everything to look as much like the castle and how the Johnsons had it during the time. And so generally the way that they came out here, it's kind of a long convoluted story, and I'm going to try and make it 5 minutes or less, was that, can you guys see me? If I stand over here, is that better? You don't have to make sense. And they figured out that he was a con. Those people, every single person in the wagon sued Scotty. His brother Warner sued him. Everyone sued him. Except Albert Johnson. So you can imagine bullets whizzing past this guy's head, and he's like, this is the most con I've ever had. And so Albert Johnson loved it so much that eventually he forgave Scotty, didn't care, and kept giving him money for the rest of his life. He started coming out here in the 1907 with Scotty as a guide. They set up camp in this area. They bought this property in 1907, 1910-ish. And he started building small things. His wife started coming out, wanted to see this place. She did not like sleeping in tents, and I heard she found a square and was like this big, it was this big, in her bed. And she said, you must build me a house, and eventually it turned into this place. And they just kept building onto this area, this dream that they had, and doing this. And Scotty stuck around, I mean, his whole life. They were best friends. You can see him sitting here. I wish I had the picture of
Albert Johnson, like, laughing maniacally at something Scotty says, and that's, like, how it always was. You could have, in the 1930s, walked into this place and seen this, seen the Johnsons with Scotty sitting here and listened to Scotty's stories. They were ridiculous and probably none of them true. It's really hard to even tell what was fact and fiction in his life. But you would have been able to actually experience that back then. And then even last year, you would have been able to walk into the castle and I would have been dressed like a guide from the time and tried to bring you back to that as well. So this is the closest we're getting right now. We are gonna get to see inside the castle in a little bit. But this stuff isn't there anymore. We have to protect it. We have to keep it from the effects of the flood that it was doing.
As we walked around the outside of the structures, you could still see the effects of the dirt and debris from the flood and the continuing cleanup.
You can probably walk under this part, but over here, you can see that we rebuilt that because this is one of the areas that was the most striking image of damage. So if you come over this way, because you can actually see it, you can see where the wall got punched out by the flood. So this whole area was inundated with mud up to here.
Wow.
In certain areas of it, because you can see the mud line right here. And that over there, you could walk straight onto the roof. It's a little low anyway, but you could walk straight onto the roof from where the mud and the flow and everything was. We had, mostly it was fire crews doing the work from Sequoia Glacier, I think. Let's just say several different parks. They came from around the country. We eventually had 250 people working on restoring this place after the flood. So in the big areas and around the trees, we could have backhoes working to get the mud and debris away. But because these are all historic walls, it had to be done by hand around all of these structures. So the amount of work that we ended up having to do to recover this place immediately from the flood.
Where did you put all the dirt?
Our visit to Scotty's Castle was awesome. It was really cool to see the history behind it and the flood stories. Until next time, this is Kay and Matt from Happy Trails Hiking. Keep on trekking.
To support the restoration of Scotty's Castle in Death Valley National Park, please go to the website for Death Valley Natural History Association or check out their Facebook page.